If you want to embed videos on your website, videos don't actually live on your website as such. They're always hosted somewhere else. So as you view a website and you watch a video, that video is most likely hosted on some dedicated video hosting service. So you don't need to worry about whether your specific e-commerce site, whether it's based on Squarespace or Shopify or Wix or whatever, most likely the video is gonna be hosted on a separate service and then you just link it into your site. So let's see how we do that now. I have opened a Squarespace mockup that I've made of a product page. We have a gallery block, which I'm then gonna edit. And the gallery block allows me to just dump in all my images. So I'm just gonna do that quick. And once that is done loading all the images, which it is now, we'll go on to add a video. We can't do that directly, so what we need to do is we need to upload it somewhere else. In this case, I'm going to show it to you on Vimeo, but it could be on other services as well. It could be YouTube, it could be 23, or whatever else is out there. I have an upload page here on Vimeo. I'm going to pull in my video and drop it in there. So it's going to take a few seconds to actually upload the thing. Then it's going to do a bit of processing. And then once we have the processing done, we'll be able to get a link to embed it. So let's go into our edit settings here. Let's close this. It's still doing some conversion. But while it's doing the conversion, I can even go in and change a few things about how it should look when it's embedded. I like to just keep the interface clean so I don't have too many things on top of my video. Just don't want the logo and all this stuff up in the corner. So we're just going to disable all of that so we just can focus on the product itself. So that's good. The other thing we would like to change is having the video looping. So we just can keep watching and watching. So we can find that over in interaction tools. I can set the video to automatically loop when it's done, and that will give a more continuous, smooth experience. And now we're going to copy in this URL up here. So I'm going to hit Command C, go back over to my Squarespace tab, and then instead of dumping anything in this area, I'm going to click the plus button in the corner, say add video. And Squarespace is kind enough to let me just paste in by Command V, pasting in the URL here, saying save, and then we apply that. And now we can see what it would be for a customer if they are going to this product page. So you can go through by clicking the thumbnails, look at the shoe from all the angles, and then finally, you can get the smooth user experience by pressing the play icon. So let's say I was using a web service that didn't allow me to just insert that simple URL. In that case, you can use an iframe, so let's try and do that now. So instead of using this URL here, we'd want to use the embed code. You don't need to understand it, but it really is just kind of a container. And within that container, it's going to load a part of the Vimeo website and show your video. So let's copy all of this. And then we're just gonna paste it over here in our gallery. So same thing, gonna hit the plus button, add video. But instead of just inserting the URL right away in this field, I'm going to press the code section, set, save, and apply. And now you see a section in here. So I hope that gives you a better understanding of how you can embed videos on your website by finding a third-party video hosting service and then inserting references into your website.